Today we're going to take a look at the browser-based reader available for Access 360. The browser-based reader allows users to access and read ebooks from the eRead Illinois Access 360 collection without the Access 360 app or additional software on their computer. The browser-based reader will work on most devices that have access to a web browser, including Chromebooks, Windows laptops and desktops, and Apple laptops and desktops. To get started, navigate to your library's magic wall. Your library's magic wall can be located by visiting eReadIL.access360.baker-taylor.com. Once you have reached your library's magic wall, click the login link in the top right corner. On the login screen, enter your library card, ID, and PIN. Not all libraries require PINs. If your library doesn't require a PIN, there will only be a line for library ID. Once you are logged in, you can browse the featured titles on the homepage, use the magnifying glass in the top right corner to do a keyword, author, or title search, or click the Browse by Subject link to browse a list of subject headings. In the top left, you will see three icons, a checkmark, an E, and headphones. These will allow you to filter by format and availability. Clicking the checkmark icon will narrow to items that are currently available, the E icon will narrow to ebooks, and the headphones will narrow to audiobooks. The browser-based reader will only work with ebooks. Audiobooks can only be listened to through the Access 360 app on a mobile device. I am going to narrow to Available Now eBooks. Clicking on the cover of a book will take me to the item info screen. From here, I can click the checkout button on the right-hand side. Once I've checked out the book, I will automatically be taken to the My Stuff section. The book I've checked out is listed under the Checked Out tab. From here, I can see by the message at the top that I can access this book through the Access 360 app. To the right of the book's cover, I see I can also download the book to Adobe Digital Editions to transfer to an e-reader, or I can read now in the browser. Clicking the Read Now button will open the book in a new tab. Hovering my mouse over the right or left side will reveal page turn arrows. I can click these or use the left and right arrow keys to navigate through the pages. Double-clicking on a word will open the options to highlight, create a note, Google, access Wikipedia, or look up the definition of a word. To use the Google, Wikipedia, or define options, you must be connected to the internet. Clicking the highlight button will open a color menu where I can choose the color of my highlight. If I double-click on another word and choose the note option, I can again choose the color as well as type a note. Once I have typed my note, I can click Save. Double-clicking a word and choosing the Google, Wikipedia, or Define options will open a bar on the left with the results. To exit the results, simply click back in the book's text or click the X at the top of the bar. Clicking the middle of the screen or hovering over the top of the window will reveal menu options. On the right is a double A icon, a pencil icon, a bookmark icon, and a question mark icon. The double A icon will allow me to make changes to the display, including font size, font and background color, and page layout. The pencil icon will bring up a list of my highlights and notes. The bookmark icon will allow me to create a bookmark, as well as to access the bookmarks I have previously created. The question mark icon will open a help menu. Notes, highlights, and bookmarks are all saved to the cloud as long as you are connected to the internet. This means that if I move to another computer and open this book, my notes, highlights, and bookmarks will all be available to me on that computer as well. If I create highlights, notes, or bookmarks while I am offline, they will sync to the cloud as soon as my computer reconnects to the internet. On the left-hand side is a menu button. Clicking this will show a table of contents as well as the option to save the book for offline access. Saving the book for offline access means that you are saving it to your browser cache so it can be read while offline. To save the book for offline access, click the down arrow icon. You will see a success message once the book is saved. Create a bookmark in your browser to easily return to accessnow.com later on. Then click Return to your book. The book is now available on your offline bookshelf on this device. To access the book offline on a different device, you would need to go through the same process on that device. Any items that you save for offline access on your device will be available to you on your offline bookshelf. This is located at accessnow.com. When you return to your bookshelf later on, it will ask you to log in with your library ID and PIN and will then allow you access to your books. To access your books on a different device, visit the library's magic wall on that device, log in, and then click on the My Stuff button on the top. Once you see your checked out items, you can click Read Now in the browser to access the book on that device and save it for offline access there as well. You are able to read the book in your browser and also in the Access 360 app on your mobile device. Unfortunately, notes and bookmarks will not sync between the app and the browser-based reader. That covers it for the browser-based reader. Happy reading!